Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Maths by Samit Deshmukh. In this video, we are solving question number 2 of last exercise, exercise number 1.5 of differentiation. So if you are new on my channel, please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notification of every newly uploaded video. And if you like the videos, please share these videos with your friends also. In question number 2, we have to find out second order derivative of the following function. But in this case, we can observe that the given function is parametric because value of x is also in terms of theta and y is also in terms of theta. And we know that if value of our variable x and y are is in terms of new variable, then that new variable is called as parameter and function is called as parametric function. Already in the last exercise, we have seen how to find out differentiation of parametric function. So easily we are able to find out a differentiation, first order differentiation of parametric function. The important thing is to find out second order, because in case of second order, we have to make the proper utilize of chain rule. So first let us try to find out its first order derivative, and later on we will see how to make the use of chain rule to find out second order derivative. So well, in this case x and y is given to us. So in solution, first we are considering value of y. So y is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta. This is the given function. We are differentiating it with respect to its parameter, means with respect to theta. So derivative of y is dy by d theta. A is a constant term, keep it as it is. Derivative of 1 is 0, minus keep it as it is. Derivative of cos x will be cos theta will be minus sine theta. So which is equal to, derivative of 1 is 0 because 1 is what? Constant term, isn't it? Now here minus into minus will become plus, plus sine theta. Sine theta into a will be equal to a sine theta. In this way, we have got the value of dy by d theta. Now we are trying to find out differentiation of x, and x is equal to what is the value of x? A into theta minus sine theta. Again differentiate it with respect to what? Theta. So derivative of x with respect to theta is denoted by dx by d theta. A is a constant term, keep it as it is. Here we can observe that theta, derivative of theta with respect to theta is what? 1 minus keep it as it is. Derivative of sine theta is what? Cos theta. In this way we have got differentiation of x also. Once these two values are known to us, we are finding value of dy by dx. To find out dy by dx, we are applying the formula to find out differentiation of parametric function, that is dy upon d theta divided by what? Dx upon d theta. This formula we have proved as a theorem to find out differentiation of parametric function. Now remaining part is just to substitute the value of dy by d theta will be equals to a sine theta, and in the denominator a into 1 minus cos theta, so which is equal to a will get cancelled. Here in the numerator and denominator, in both cases we are able to apply half angle formula. According to half angle formula, sine theta can be written as what? 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, and in the denominator 1 minus cos theta can be replaced by 2 sine square theta by 2. Just we are applying half angle formula in both numerator and denominator. Let us see what we'll get here. So therefore dy upon dx is equals to, from numerator and denominator first cancel 2, after cancelling 2 then observe that sin theta by 2 and 1 sin theta by 2 from denominator will get cancelled, means what we are getting in the numerator? Cos theta by 2, and in the denominator see what we are getting? Sin theta by 2, and cos upon sin will be equals to what? Cot theta by 2. So value of dy by dx is known to us. Now we are finding second order derivative. So now let us try to find out value second order derivative, means d2y upon dx square. So which is equals to, now to see we are differentiating with respect to what? X. We are differentiating dy by dx with respect to x, but value of dy by dx is in terms of what? Theta. So means this, to differentiate this function, we have to differentiate it with respect to what? Which variable? Theta. But question is to differentiate it with respect to what? X. So that's why we are making the use of making the proper use of chain rule to find out second order derivative in case of what? Parametric function. So try to understand how we are using here chain rule. First, let us revise the chain rule. Suppose that if we are to find out value of dy by dx, and if value of y is in terms of u and u is in terms of x, at that time in the numerator keep dy as it is, in the denominator dx keep it as it is. If y is differentiable function of u, at that time we are dividing by du and we are multiplying by du. So dy and dx keep it as it is, just divide by du and multiply by du. This we have proved as a theorem also, which is called as what? Chain rule. Here d2y upon dx square, can I write it as derivative of dy by dx, isn't it? So which is equals to, now observe the chain rule. So dy by dx, consider this whole term as y, dy by dx. So here we are keeping this term as it is, dy by dx as it is, and here d by dx, dx I am shifting here, isn't it? यहाँ पे हमने क्या किया था, numerator में dy as it is रखो, denominator में dx, dx थोड़ा side में लिया था, यहाँ पे भी dx थोड़ा side में लिया, getting it? And consider this as y, dy, dy keep it as it is, dx we are shifting on this side. Now here we can observe that value of y is in terms of what? Theta. यहाँ पे y की value differentiable थी with respect to u, that's why we are dividing by du and multiplying by du, but here value of dy by dx is in terms of theta, that's why I am dividing by d theta and I am multiplying by d theta, means simply we have make the use of what here, chain rule, isn't it? dy, consider this as y, dy upon dx can be written as dy upon d theta divided by dx upon d theta according to our chain rule. Remaining part is just to substitute the value, d by d theta keep it as it is, dy by dx, its value is equal to cot theta by 2 into d theta by dx will be equals to. So observe here, value of dx upon d theta is this one. Let us denote it by equation number first. What is the value of dx upon d theta? A into 1 minus cos theta. So here we does not require dx by d theta, we will require d theta by dx, means its reciprocal, means its reciprocal will be 1 upon a into 1 minus cos theta. Hope you are getting it. On the left hand side, if we are taking reciprocal, we will get d theta by dx, and on this side 1 upon a into 1 minus cos theta, we will require the value of d theta by dx, which we have substituted from equation first. So we are substituting this value from equation number what? First. Hope you are getting it. Remaining part is just simplification part. So which is equal to, what is derivative of cot theta by 2? It is in the form of cot f of x. So its derivative is minus cosec square, cosec square f of x. What is f of x? Theta by 2 into its derivative. Into its derivative. What is derivative of theta by 2? Is it equal to 1 by 2? Yes. Into, in the denominator, a keep it as it is, 1 minus cos theta, according to half angle formula, can be replaced by 2 sine square theta by 2. Try to understand it. So which is equal to, here minus keep it as it is, in the denominator 2a into 2 will be equal to 4a, and here cosec square theta by 2 keep it as it is. If we are shifting sine square theta by 2 in the numerator, it will become what? Cosec square theta by 2, means simply we are taking reciprocal of what? Sine. So which is equal to minus 1 upon 4a keep it as it is, here cosec square theta by 2 into cosec square theta by 2 will be cosec theta by 2 raised to power what? 4. Cosec square theta by 2 into cosec square theta by 2 will be cosec square theta by 2 raised to power 4. 2 plus 2 will be equal to what? 4, and this will be the second order derivative of this function. Hope the method is very clear to you. Already we will have this formula to find out derivative of what? Parametric function, to find out first order derivative. But to find out second order derivative, we have to make the use of what? Chain rule here. So you are able to give also reason also here by chain rule. This result we are getting applying what? Chain rule. So in this way we have got second order derivative of this parametric function. So in this case also the given function is parametric function. So the method which you have applied in the last example, same method we are applying here. First find out derivative of y with respect to parameter 280. So y is equal to 280 is given to us. We are differentiating it with respect to t. So differentiate it with respect to t. Derivative of y with respect to t is denoted by dy by dt. On this side, 2 derivative of 280 will be equal to 2a. And x is equal to, what is the value of x? 280 square. So again, we are differentiating it also with respect to parameter t. So derivative of x with respect to t is dx by dt. On this side, 2a is a constant term. What is derivative of t square with respect to t will be equal to 2t, and 2a into 2t will be 4at. Once these two values are known to us, then find out value of dy by dx. So therefore, dy upon dx will be equals to, so we are applying here formula to find out derivative of parametric function. So dy upon dt divided by dx upon dt, because t is here parameter. So what is dy upon dt will be equal to 2a, and dx upon dt will be equal to 4at. So which is equal to 2a, 2a will get cancelled, and here we are getting 1 by t as our value of first order derivative. So which implies that dy upon dx is equals to 1 upon t. Here we can observe that dy upon dx is in terms of what? T. So we are not able to differentiate it with respect to t. But to find out second order derivative, we have to differentiate it with respect to what? X. So here, differentiate it with respect to x. So now we are finding second order derivative. What is derivative of dy by dx? That is d2y upon dx square. But on this side directly we are not able to find out differentiation, because this side is in terms of what? T. So that's why we are applying chain rule. So here d2y upon dx square means, is it derivative of what? Dy upon dx. So which is equal to, chalo ab yaha pe ise y consider karo, dy as it is, dy as it is, consider it as y, and dx I am taking on this side. So this value of this dy by dx is in terms of t, that's why I am dividing by dt, because this function can be differentiable with respect to what? T. Since I am dividing by t, that's why I am multiplying by t. Here this result we have obtained by applying chain rule, isn't it? So which is equal to, now remaining part is just to substitute the value. What is the value of dy by dx? That will be equal to 1 by t. Better way, denote this value by equation first and this value by equation second. Dy by dx I am replacing by its value 1 by t from equation number second. And dt by dx, dt by dx means reciprocal of dx by dt. So if we are taking reciprocal of this side, we will get dt by dx. And what value of dt by dx we will get? 1 upon 4at. We does not require dx by dt, we require dt by dx. Means we have to take the reciprocal of this term, and on this side reciprocal of 4at will be 1 upon 4at. Hope you all got it. So which is equal to, now derivative of 1 by t with respect to t is minus 1 upon t square. We know that derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. It is the standard formula. Into 1 upon 4at, keep it as it is. So which is equal to, in the numerator we are getting minus 1, and in the denominator t square into 480 will be 4at cube, and this is our value of second order derivative. Now see the example number third. In this case, what is the given function? X is equal to sine theta and y is equal to sine cube theta. Here also we can observe that value of x is also in terms of theta and y is also in terms of theta, means it is parametric function. And already in the last two examples we have seen how to find out differentiation, first order differentiation also, and second order differentiation of parametric function. Second order differentiation we are finding applying what? Chain rule, isn't it? So but here coincidentally we are able to simplify this function, isn't it? So that's why we are using the simplification method. It is possible in this example, so that easily we are able to differentiate it, isn't it? So here we can observe that x is equal to sine theta, means sine cube theta is the value of x cube, isn't it? So sine theta is x, means sine cube theta will be equal to what? X cube. So hope you are getting it. Otherwise, this sine cube theta, can I replace it by sine theta whole bracket cube? Isn't it? It can be written in this form also. Now sine theta I am replacing by x cube. So what value of y we have got here? Y is equal to x cube, isn't it? Now this function becomes what? Explicit function. So easily we are able to differentiate it. So differentiate it with respect to x. So differentiate with respect to x. So derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx, and on this side derivative of x cube is 3x square. In this way we have got first order differentiation. To find out second order differentiation, again we are differentiating it. Again differentiate it with respect to what? X. So derivative of y with respect to x is denoted by d2y upon dx square, and on this side 3, keep it as it is. What is derivative of x square? That is 2x. So will be equal to 6x. In this way we have got second order derivative also. So the differentiation is completed, but question is to find out the differentiation at theta is equal to what? Pi by 2. So that's why we have to using this substitution, we have to find out a value of x in terms of theta. So again observe here. Now here we can observe that the value of d2y upon dx square is in terms of what? X. But question is to find out this second order derivative at theta is equals to what? Pi by 2. So if theta is equal to pi by 2, at that time what is the value of x? That we are trying to find out, because here this value is in terms of x. Agar ye value theta mein hoti thi, toh hum directly theta ki value pi by 2 substitute kar sakte the. But now when theta is equal to pi by 2, at that time we are trying to find out value of x, isn't it? So now when theta is equal to pi by 2, we are trying to find out value of x. X is equal to sine. What is x? Is equal to sine theta, but theta I am replacing by pi by 2. So implies that x is equal to pi by 2 means 90, and we know that sine 90 is equal to 1, means when theta is equal to pi by 2, at that time x is equal to 1. So therefore the value of d2y upon dx square at x is equals to 1, at x is equals to 1, will be equals to 6 into 1. So which is equal to what? 6 into 1 will be equal to 6. Means indirectly we can say that when theta is equal to pi by 2, our second order derivative will be equal to what? 6. Because this value we have obtained using same value of theta. When theta is equal to pi by 2, at that time x will become sine pi by 2, and sine pi by 2 will be equal to 1, means value of x is equal to 1. In this way we have got the differentiation at x is equals to 1, means what? At theta is equals to what? X is equal to 1 means what? Theta is equal to pi by 2. So at theta is equal to pi by 2, value of second order derivative will be equal to 6. Now see the last fourth example. In this case also value of x is in terms of theta and y is also in terms of theta, means given function is parametric function, and we have to find out second order derivative at theta is equal to pi by 4. So first let us differentiate y with respect to parameter theta. So what result we are getting here? Dy upon d theta will be equals to b as it is. What is derivative of sine theta? Will be equals to cos theta. And now we are considering x. X is equal to a cos theta. So differentiate it with respect to our parameter theta. So derivative of x with respect to theta is dx by theta. On this side a is a constant term, keep it as it is. Derivative of cos theta with respect to theta is minus sine theta. Once both the values are known to us, so we are able to find out value of dy by dx, means first order derivative, applying the formula to find out differentiation of parametric function, that is dy by d theta divided by dx upon d theta. What is dy upon d theta? Will be equals to b cos theta. So replace it by b cos theta, and in the denominator replace dx by d theta by its value minus a sine theta, minus a sine theta. So which is equal to minus b by a, keep it as it is. Cos upon sine will be equals to what? Cot theta. In this way we have got first order derivative. Now we are trying to find out second order derivative, and we know that to find out second order derivative we have to apply chain rule. So d2y upon dx square will be equals to, can I write it as derivative of dy by dx. Yes, it can be written as derivative of what? Dy by dx, which is equal to, now according to chain rule, d, consider this whole term as y, dy upon dx means dy, what is y? Dy by dx. Keep this term as it is. This dx I am writing on this side. Now, here we can observe that the value of dy by dx is in terms of theta, means its differentiation can be found out only with respect to theta. So, that's why I am dividing by d theta and I am multiplying by d theta, and this result we have got using chain rule. So, which is equal to here d by d theta, keep it as it is, d by d theta. Now, substitute the value of dy by dx. What is the value of dy by dx? Minus b upon a cot theta, minus b upon a cot theta into. Now, we are substituting the value of d theta by dx, which is reciprocal of what? Dx upon d theta. What is its reciprocal? 1 upon minus a sine theta. Just we have substituted the value of dy by dx, and d theta by dx will be minus a sine theta. Its reciprocal is minus a sine theta. So, minus b by a is a constant term. Keep it as it is. What is derivative of cot? Will be minus cosec square theta. And here into minus, keep it as it is, in the denominator a also as it is. Just simply we are taking reciprocal of sine. What is reciprocal of sine? Will be equals to cosec theta. Hope you are getting it. Just we have taken reciprocal of sine. Keep remaining term as it is. So which is equal to minus into minus will become plus, and plus into minus will become minus. B, keep it as it is, in the denominator a into a is a square, and cos square, cosec square into cosec will become cosec cube theta. Getting it? This is the value of what? D2y upon dx square. But question is to find out the value of d2y upon dx square at theta is equal to what? Pi by 4. So that's why on this side I am replacing this theta by pi by 4. Minus b upon a square, keep it as it is. Here we will get cosec cube pi by 4. Just simply replace theta by pi by 4. So, which is equal to minus b upon a square, keep it as it is, cosec pi by 4 will be equal to what? Root 2. Keep this cube as it is. Cosec pi by 4 means 45. So, which is equal to what? Is cube of 2 will be equal to 2 root 2. 2 root 2 into minus b will be minus 2 root 2 b, and in the denominator a square, keep it as it is. This is nothing but our required value of second order derivative. In this way, we have completed all the four examples from question number 2. If you think that these videos are helpful to you, so please like the videos and share these videos with your friend. In the next video, we are solving question number 3, all the example from question number 3.